Wizard 2020 is saying no. What's your objection, mate? Are you afraid that we can't do it? All right, welcome to Operation Foolish Vagabond. Hopefully we're not the foolish ones in this mission. We are going to do this supply raid with mainly rookies slash squaddy-like characters, where we're going to try to level up some more. It's not a timed mission. It is one of the missions where we do not take any major strike back if we would not do it. So there's like not too much of a downside, I suppose, is what I'm saying. We could take a little bit of a hit on our economy if we would fail this one. But other than that, we should be pretty much okay. Yeah, Wizard 2020 had an objection on the nanoscale vest. I can fully understand that, bro. Nanoscale vests pretty much suck. But hear out my logic and then judge on your own. The strongest enemy that we're currently having, or the average enemies that we're currently having, are advanced advanced soldiers, so advanced troopers and advanced officers. They can hit up to 6 points of damage. If they crit, that's 9 points of damage. The strongest enemy hit-wise that we do have is the Archon and the Andromedon. The Archon can crit for up to 9. The Andromedon can hit for up to 7 and can then basically poison you for 1 to 3 points of damage. And you maybe if you hear these numbers, which are all more or less adding up to 9, you might understand why having 9 points of damage, nine hit points, is basically not the optimal value at this moment in the game. You either want to be a glass cannon, full stop, and just have like 1 hit point, no matter who's shooting at you, you drop down, or you're trying to mitigate one shot, which I was trying to do, knowing the damage values of our current enemies. And that's the reason why I have chosen the vest. Like, who you source with his 10 hit points is still pretty fucking weak. But yeah, we need to start somewhere. So yeah, that's about it. Hope that explanation made sense. That was the rationale behind it. Mutants, by the way, can crit for up to 9 points of damage as well. So it's a little bit like a conspiracy theory. Everyone now can crit for up to 9. Moving on target location. So we're taking single movements, like I was saying earlier. Let's just make sure that we're not fucking this one up. Well, we want to, from a holistic perspective, obviously down here there's nothing. There's going to be like this pathway in the middle. Normally there is some high ground over here, but we are this time missing it. Instead, they have chosen the tiles with the river in it. So this is not going to have any high cover at all. But there is some high ground here. Where we nevertheless need to be a little bit careful. It's this over here, and we're basically trying to go for this high ground over there. Like I was saying, we're having a lot of rookies here, so it's not in our intention to overly fast try to kill all of them. We just want to make sure that we survive, basically. And it's probably going to be less of a steamroll than the last times. So, if I remember correct, this was one of the maps where we had the turning point with our troll run. I know that wall here. In the last run that we did, we basically got poisoned here and a couple of characters died exactly at that wall. So what I'm trying to say here is there's a high chance that there are going to be packs around here. The probability is rather high to encounter more than one pack. Aliens are taking their time, which means all of them are actually taking turns. It's a good indicator for you guys, so that you know that the aliens are moving. If it takes so much time, they are usually taking moves. And there's nothing wrong with aliens taking moves, it's just you should know it. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, that's our last one. We could go for Haywire protocol, but we're still in concealment, and that's worth so much at the moment that I don't want to waste it, honestly. Yeah. So this one here is. I think this mission is going to be a little bit more. Tension intensive, because I don't know about the strength of the remaining packs. Wow, but they move towards the car, right? Now that has been a mistake. Enemies should never move towards cars. Cars can explode, and that deals a lot of extra damage. Good, let's use Ansys Trail here as a scout. I like him as the front line. No, they basically moved to the next car. Yeah, that's bad. I was hoping that they would stay at the car, but that's okay. Maybe with a little bit of a double movement, we can motivate them to come back. So we're getting everyone in position now for our first fight of the evening. Yeah, no, it's not the first fight of the evening, of course. It is the first fight in this mission. The first fight in this mission. I would want to go here, but there is the danger of someone being directly in there, spotting us out, and then we would be in a bad position. So, yeah, let's just take him to here for now. Trying to go for full cover, as you guys can see, basically taking positions where we are in a secure spot. And for Zarp, I'm taking an aggressive position because we are probably being forced to use face-off, and I want to be able to see as many guys as possible. Good, so... Let's see if they are coming back. That would be my preferred option. Them moving into our direction, and we're basically greeting them with a nice little grenade. Of course, they aren't. Too bad. Well, it's not the end of the world. Let's take a look inside. Of course, our scout is going to keep on scouting. We can now take double moves. We have produced sound in the last turn anyways, so might as well continue to do so. Actually, I'm actively trying to notify one of the packs at, regarding our presence. So I want them to come a little bit closer, because if all of them are patrolling, there is a high chance that they are going to meet somewhere. And if packs are meeting somewhere, they are taking this moment of dialogue. And I'm not kidding. They are really standing there together, sometimes like a couple of rounds, basically waiting. I don't know if that was the representation of XCOM kind of trying to showcase that the admins are having a conversation with one another. But yeah, that's exactly what happens then, yeah? You can see... These guys basically moved up and said, like, yeah, what's up? And the Vipers up here were like, yeah, what's up, brothers? And now they are now interacting, quote-unquote, with one another. Good news, these little fellows over here cannot go down, And we're definitely going to use a grenade in order to blow up the whole car. So they are going to take 7 points of damage, plus the explosion of this car is dealing another 6 points of damage, which is enough to kill every little bugger. Good. Let us proceed up here. I'm just getting everyone into position right now. And wow, was that... Have I just seen a mech up over here? I think so. So I think there was a mech like literally here. I have no idea why I can't see it anymore, but I'm pretty sure, like 90%+, that there has been a mech up there. Yeah. No. He will be revealed. Sorry, that was a mismove, because if we're now engaging on someone, he will be revealed. He doesn't have Phantom as an ability, so we need to pull him also on top of the roof. No other option available. So we really want to single pull now. Double pulls would not work for us. And probably I should have pulled him a little bit back, knowing that there is one here. Because they can now move over here, then he's trapped, and we could maybe lose his concealment as well, which we clearly don't want to, right? I'm really not sure about this mech, because here's what I think. Sometimes there is a visual bug. I don't know if you have noticed this ever. And the visual bug is leaving one of the units behind, whilst the other units are all moving. And the mech was, I'm pretty sure, 99% that the mech was with these guys, okay? If that has been the case, then he always has been positioned here, but his visual representation remained up here. And I think that's also the reason why we haven't seen him moving away at the moment. Yeah. Full stop. I think that's the reason. All right. What's up here? Like, okay. Well, this one here. Yeah. What's up? So from here onwards... they would have vision. This one here is still cool. So I would say these fields here, like this here is the first, this one here is officially still safe, but let's rather be safe than sorry. So we're just moving up to here, and that's about it. We can move up to here. That's good. So my suggestion now would be, let's start the encounter and see how we're going to deal with it. He doesn't have salvo, so let's not use him. JC Phoenix does have salvo, but no. Let's start with I Imperator. Good, guys. It's on, by the way. Last reading of the chat before we go ham. Moments of dialogue coming this fall. The lives of an advent. Yo, brother, have you eaten an advent burger lately? Yeah, they are so tasty. That's about their dialogue. That's about their dialogue. If we position it too far, like here, we would basically pull multiple packs at once. So I'm a little bit careful not to pull too many. Like, we know that there's a pack behind there, and I don't want to open the box of the Pandora here. Grenade! Advent Burger. No one knows what they're made of, but they are super delicious. Wow, there was so much extra damage behind. So I think we have just pulled this guy. I think. But I am not really sure. Wow, who you sauce? No offense, brother, but your aiming needs some improvements, like 31% from high ground. Wow. Wow. All right, let's try to find a position where we can take a shot. I think moving Zarp over here is not the worst decision ever. Yeah, that's fine. We get lightning hands and just another shot. 2 times 50-50, that should be one hit. Come on, brother. Yeah, good job, Zarp, good job. So let me just move over here, mainly to spot out whether or not we're still okay. We should be okay. Like they can just see them. And as far as the game is concerned, just to tell you a little bit about the AI. So it's not like they have noticed any of this, okay? There was a huge explosion there. These guys just literally stood behind here having their Advent Burger dialogues. And these guys, I don't know, were taking a piss against these little chests here. All of this exploded and they're totally like, okay, whatever. They have noticed it and they're not going to investigate. But if I'm now going to take one more step here, all of them will be like, shit, have you heard someone moving there? So let's investigate immediately. That's the reason why I am not moving, but instead just trying to move these guys up here. Getting into a little bit better position for an Overwatch. Yeah, and I'm not going to take any risks now because we're at the end of the turn. Who you saw us? I'll get you your kill on this mission. Don't you worry. But for now, we need you in the back. I don't want to sacrifice you. The Joker should have the last, but not the first laugh. Maybe the first and the last laugh, but the last is more important. Advent Burgers again. Yeah, I'm taking a double move here just to motivate them to come a little bit closer because I still think that they are super defensive, which they do not necessarily need to. I wish they would be just a little bit more aggressive here. Definitely, we would want to go for an Overwatch trap. Question from the chat: do I have any tips for starting out? Gorkart, I do not only have any tips for starting out. I proud myself in being the author of one of the most read guides about starting out in XCOM 2. And if you are interested, check out this Reddit guide, and I would appreciate if you like it to leave a comment to tell others that you like the guide and that you have enjoyed reading it. And then we're basically even. I have invested time to write something that is useful for you, and you told others that you found it useful. You're most welcome, brother. You're most welcome. And if you have any questions after the guide, by all means, please ask me. But I guess the guide will answer 90% of your initial questions. And the last 10% we can answer right here. Good. Still, I'm just taking single moves here, guys, because I want to use the our scout here in order to locate the other packs. I know that there are still at least 4 more packs around. Yeah, that is some guide, brother. That's some guide. It took me a little while to compile all of it, but when I started with XCOM 2, I was reading guides on IGN and other websites like GameStar, and I'm not going to discriminate the guides, so don't get me wrong, but these guides basically contain the 10 best tips to play XCOM 2, and out of the 10 tips, I personally, from my experience, found 8 of them to be super crappy. Like, they were really, really bad. It was not that the guide itself was badly written, like, that's one thing. It was mainly that the information within the guide was either incorrect or simply not applicable, and that motivated me to think about writing a guide on my own. Yeah, and that's, by the way, hopefully a nice little set of Overwatch shots incoming. Yeah, great, wonderful, wonderful. Look at that, the 20% high ground really pay out. We killed 2 of them immediately, and the other 2 are now super scared. Good fucking job, guys. Good fucking job. Sure, bookmark it. You can also find it if you're going for XCOM 2 guide and just type in legendary, for instance. It should be the first thing that pops up on Google, except they downvoted or downgraded me, but it should be the first thing that, at least it has been for a longer period of time. Good, if we advance more than our current position, we might run into the problem of not being able to see them properly or to pull another pack. Like, we don't want to go onto this ledge just to stand in the open and find out, yeah, that it was a bad idea, right? We're going to save this grenade just in case things do not turn out as expected. We're not going to explode this shit here because, again, the game here is a little tip for you guys, okay? Because I know that you always are interested in these little tips. I told you that the game is giving you all of the information that is necessary. So crates and other explosive items are only explosive if something is within the range of its explosion radius. Currently, these crates here do have 2 tiles of explosion. So it tells us the pack from here just moved to here and is now standing around that crate. Just to keep in mind, so you do have a tracker where everyone basically is on the map, okay? Just to keep that on your radar. No, that's the wrong guy. That's the wrong guy. I really wish we could take another position here, which doesn't completely suck or expose us too much. Like, all of the positions either pull new packs because they are too far away. Like, this here is the farthest that we can go, because this is where our scout has basically triggered them and encountered them. So we need to go down here. All of this in front here would be a bad idea because it could trigger something. And the reason why I jumped down is I still want to soften up this advent. So in case we're throwing a grenade here, we will finish both of them. And now we do have solid shots to actually kill these guys, which we're going to take. That's the logic. Always have a backup plan to make sure that that in case things are not working out, that you still be able to do it. And who you source, that's your first chance, brother. 31%, okay? Here you go, man. Shit. Anyone knows who the first person, not Phyrexis themselves, to win Legendary Ironman? I know there had been someone posting, like, literally on the day after the release, but he got flamed. He got flamed pretty hard because people thought that he has cheated. Like, it's the typical situation. If you're good at something and people cannot accept that you're good at something, they will automatically say he must have cheated because it's not working. But I can't remember the name of the guy. Hey, Saiken, may I ask if they fixed performance issues yet? Twitch certainly has fixed their performance issues. If we have performance issues, then it's on my side this time, I hope not, but it would be on my side. At least it's fluent for me at the moment, and I saw that others said, yeah, it's fluent as well. In terms of performance of the stream, I'm already looking for gaming cards. That are helping to make the in-game stream even more fluently. So that will be something that I could try to look into for the future. For now, for now it is what it is. What do we have? We do have a scope and an expanded magazine. If we would have a stock, we would have killed him because he's down to 1 HP. And since I don't want to take any risks, I know it is wasteful to use a grenade here, but yeah, moving there with run and gun is only a 70% chance to hit him, and then all of my guys would currently be in the open, and I don't want to risk his concealment. So naturally, the only choice to 100% kill him this turn is a grenade. Let's put a grenade up here, so in case there is someone hiding in the back, we'll just kill them as well. No, there ha hasn't been someone. We just exploded the other. Wow. The explosion of the car has triggered a chain reaction. Are you really telling me that the explosion of this car has literally just triggered this chain reaction? So that is really stupid. And to make matters worse, we do have someone in open cover here. Wow. Okay. Let's very, very conservatively think that through. We know that there is a last pack back here. Good. We can't afford to pull that pack as well. But we certainly can afford to kill this pack here. How are we going to deal with it? We know that there is a pack back here. That's knowledge that we already obtained. If we move too far into this one, the chance is nearly 100% to get busted. This guy here is an 80% chance to take the shot and actually kill him. So what I would propose here is to go into full cover. We do have run and gun, and take a look whether or not we find guys back here. If the answer is no, we can't see anyone else than the normal pack, we'll put ourselves here, which effectively tells the whole pack here, dude, there is someone over here, you need to focus on him. And they hopefully will ignore him. Plus, if we kill this guy, we get implacable. But one thing's for sure, we will not keep our concealment for now. See, and that's the squad that I was talking about. And luckily, I haven't decided to go two balls deep here. So we're going to go back because we know this place here is something where we cannot see them. So they are currently there. We are ignoring them. We are, however, having a clear line of sight, and we need to definitely take the shot here to kill him. We get implacable. I'm not going to move. I'm going to stay here. I know that I'm in range, and we hope that they are going to focus on me. The chances are not that great since he has no cover at all, but the chances exist. So, yeah. That was really bad luck. That was really bad luck. So not very surprisingly, we're of course pulling the last pack, but I don't care too much about pulling them because they can't act within this round. That's okay. I have more problems about all of these guys here to act within the round, because these guys are really dangerous. All right, that's the first hit. Of course, a crit. One Overwatch. Lancer's got a lance. Lancer's got a lance. They will always try to lance, and he was on untouchable, so the plan worked out. And we got a critical, which sucks, but the plan worked out. Please don't shoot. Fuck. That's really bad. That was our second best specialist, by the way. Pretty much sacrificed due to a shitty chain reaction that we couldn't have foreseen. Pretty bad, guys. Pretty bad. So I am thinking about, we do have really a couple of guys here that we need to take care about. We do have Salvo, and we're going to definitely go balls deep here. So that's the first gas grenade. He got himself implacable for repositioning, but he also got a second action, which was nice. I'm just thinking about grenades and shit at the moment. Like, this one here could clear out quite a bit to make sure that we are fine again. It's really sad that the last guy actually killed him. Until the end of the turn, it really looked like they would be basically focusing on everyone a little bit, and we would be fine, but... Watch those supply crates. If you destroy them, there won't be anything left for us to recover once the area is secured. But it certainly hasn't been the case, unfortunately. Yeah, he dodged that one. I'm just thinking about exploding the trunk back here, which would basically kill this guy. And that's probably the best idea. Stun Lancer can be killed. This is just a 75% shot. We can probably also kill him. Pretty sure we can. So let's take the explosion. It will reduce our supplies a little bit that we'll get. But yeah. Overall, pretty much worth it. Okay, so this here is who you saw us now. With hopefully a solid hit, 70%+. Come on, brother. That's what I wanted to see. I can depend on you, mate. Good fucking job. You just killed him. Like a professional. Yeah, the guy back here, I want to double check if we can reach the advent back there. It somehow seems we can't really. No. So what's the alternative? We could go down here, which is half cover, or here, which is probably the best bet, because I don't want to cluster them up like noobs and then be super surprised when the opponent decides to, yeah, surprise, here's the grenade, right? That would just suck. And we could take advantage of using run and gun. If that wouldn't mean that there are five more sectors, seven. Wow. How is this even possible? Wow, we can't move this guy, and this handsome fellow here needs to die. Today it's it seems to be a little bit of a, I don't know, struggling day to say the least. Good. So this mutant is down. I'm not like super anxious about this guy over here, and I couldn't care less about the sectoids, to be honest. But I do have a certain, let's call it reservation about this mutant, because the mutant has a pretty strong attack. 17 hit points are okay. I don't care so much. That should be fine. We can't kill him, however, in one turn. Like, I can't get there. I don't want to pull yet another pack, so it's probably a shot that we are going to take, no matter what. So what we're going to do is let's try to get here into full cover and try to kill this Lancer, so we at least prevent like two shots on him at the same time. And the chances here would be shitty, as always. I wouldn't have expected anything else, but he's poisoned. So let's just give him the good old grenade to make sure that this guy is going to die. Also, we're in full cover, which is pretty good, so we're not taking any extra damage. Implacable, we don't need to move, in my opinion. Instead, the next grenade is going to definitely soften these guys up. I promise you guys that we're going to have a hell of a mission here, and I hope I didn't underpromise. Like, this one here is definitely tough, and with the exception of this unfortunate death, everything went pretty much according to plan. Pretty much according to plan. Okay, so what's it going to be? The mutant double moved? Wow, that's really stupid. Like, double movement, I wouldn't have expected him to do that. We will have a shit ton of zombies now. I already expect this, because they will use their reanimation skill quite intensively. But, oh yeah, that's good. Run away. Oh, that's even better. And hunker down. Yeah, that's not bad. That's actually not bad. They have done a pretty good job in retreating him. We just need to pay a little bit attention now with all of the zombies and with the vast majority of these psi abilities. We will be targeted for many psi spins next turn. And even if the chance of them individually succeeding is low, I would assume that overall they will have a decent chance of at least mind controlling one of us. Yeah, now we got six, seven more zombies. Lovely. You gotta love how the sectoids are creating more enemies. Textbook example of how shit blows up in XCOM. Yeah, we just got XCOM'd. That's why they call it's XCOM baby. I still got the last poison grenade here, like last gas bomb, and I think we're going to use it in order to wreak some havoc here. This here is the best that I can think about. It'll poison some of the sectoids. For most of the sectoids, it's going to be a one shot. They will be hit for 7 points of damage, plus the ongoing The ongoing damage is 3 points. So these three sectoids effectively are already dead. He's unfortunately not already dead, so we need to work on that still. And he's also not dead, so yeah. A little bit more to work on, though. All right, our rookie is thirsting for blood. The question is, how can we manage his thirst for blood? Probably we can go here. I'm not afraid about the sectoids and their shooting abilities. Like, their gun can hit for 3 to 5 if they crit, and that's about it. But this here is going to flank the sectoid, and that's actually a chance for one shot kill. Good job, man. Who you saw? You really, really, really digged it this run. I like it. He already killed 2. Very, very good. I think we're going to take this shot, although I could face off. But face off would be, quote unquote, only illusionally high amounts of damage. All the guys that we could face off are going to die anyways from the poison. So let's try to kill the mutant, because he's really the most dangerous foe in the group.
Target,
yeah, target eliminated. That's exactly what I wanted to hear. So we can now take a repositioning. Like, all of them are going to die, right? We now need to get into a position where we can actually see more of the sectoids from the backline. Give me a second to calculate that. None of these positions would work. We need to take a single... Yeah, that one would work. But it is an open cover. But then again, I just told you guys I'm not super afraid about their ability to take shots. So we're going to into open cover, not pulling anything. And it's giving us a very pretty and sweet line here. So this one here could actually be a kill. Or it is an 82% shot that is just missing, like so many shots that we have had before. Answers trail, please. Good boy, good boy. So it's just one more sectoid here. I don't know which zombie belongs to him. Probably one of these guys in the middle here. But this sectoid is the only one who is still kind of active. I'm just going to move back, because Ancestral only has 7 hit points and zombies can crit up to 6. I don't want to have any shenanigans going on there. Question from the chat, how about Advent Priests and Sniper? This is going to be one of the plans for the next discussion. I.e. these are the mods that I was looking into, and I do have a very strong preference to use them. They seem to be super fun. But I wanted to introduce it to the chat all at once after the quote unquote season is over, just to make sure that we got a little that everyone's on the same page. And I also want to motivate guys to come up with their own ideas of what I could play. So it's going to be again an open quote unquote questionnaire. We do have a Google document, and if you guys already want to insert your ideas for next season, let me shortly link you the Google document. I think it was this command. No. Shit, I can't remember my own commands. Yeah, there's the Google document. If you click onto it, everyone has editing rights. So since we only have mature and non-trolly viewers, Our experience with the document was that nothing has been deleted out of it. So if you have ideas, just put it into there. Everyone will benefit from it if the ideas are good. We'll definitely take it up, and I'm pretty much happy to play whatever you guys want to see. And there had been some really great ideas and suggestions already. So yeah, if you do have ideas, wow, 95% miss. That's interesting. If you have ideas, just put it into there, and I can promise you I'll read all of the comments. Good. So this here looks like an extra kill for who you saw, because he needed to reload anyways. And as I told you guys, zombies are just worth as much as any other enemy is. So basically by killing them, you get as much XP as you would get by killing a gatekeeper or a sectopod. So if you have the chance, just kill them. I don't know, is there still another pack around? It starts getting a little bit strange that we have so many enemies here. It's one of these what the fuck moments when you realize, wow, and they even keep on missing. Yeah, he will now take a shot because all of his psi abilities are in cooldown, so yeah. That was foreseeable. He's usually shooting for the guys in the least amount of cover, and I wouldn't be surprised if the zombie gets off a hit. Warknife, are you baiting the troll out of me? Yeah, to a certain degree, I'm certain I am baiting it out. Not with actually deleting content of others, because the result of doing so is just bad for everyone. It's that I need to think about another method of getting input, but I'm pretty sure that you guys are going to be fine with it. I am baiting, however, the troll in you by coming up with a suggestion of really crazy shit that I could play with your input, e.g. troll runs, e.g. Viewer troll runs, and so on and so forth. So these kinds of trollish attitude, I'm very, very much supporting, because I think it's hilarious. And having a good laugh all together, that's definitely something that I would want to have. That's definitely something I would like to have. So we are now reloading. Situation is stabilized again. I'm a little bit concerned, though, that there is still yet another pack somewhere. We have one grenade left, but obviously we are not having any more healing supplies, because our healer fucking died, so yeah. No shit, Sherlock, you lost your healing ability when the healer died. It's usually the person in the whole group who should die the least or the last or take the least amount of damage. So having him in the open and then triggering another pack, like unintentionally, that was a bad chain reaction. Kushurik, I like to play hardcore as well. I had grenade damage fall off and Grimmy's loot as well as more as squad size upgrade 6+, custom lubrication classes and expanded enemy disciples. A lot of run today due to sector pods and gatekeepers when having full magnetic and only Kevlar. Yeah, that sounds like a pretty nice run. I'm a little bit shying away from increasing our squad, because as you can see, it already is more or less possible with only 6 guys. So yeah, it's nice as it is to have even more potential soldiers at your disposal. We also need to be mindful that the challenge rating is still being kept. And as it stands, I think eight soldiers will be a little bit of an overkill, I fear. I'm on it. That's why you're followed. Keep playing hardcore. Don't worry, mate. My inner nature is to take on hardcore challenges. So naturally, I, on my own, will definitely come up with hardcore challenges every once in a while. But keep it like, but let's regard it like this. If every day would be Super Bowl, like no one would watch it after after a certain time. So there needs to be also other sorts of games, like the normal NBA, NFL, whatever season, or the normal leagues. If every day is a Champions League finale, no one would like ever watch that day in, day out. So, and that's also the reason why I want to vary a little bit, just to also keep fresh ideas about it and not do the same strategy over and over again, right? Because there is also a limited learning effect. Some hardcore viewers will appreciate it, but I can only tell you, even though we haven't had a hardcore-ish session in the troll run, it was actually pretty difficult because the guys in the troll run trolled me pretty hard. I had one of our rangers, it was Who You Saws, who was basically running around with this fucking skulljack day in and day out. I had a sniper, Strelok, who refuses to use anything else than real grenades. Which, did he really move into the car? Are you shitting me? All right, so that's hilarious on its own. He moved into the car, basically saying, "What up?" I'm pretty sure it's the last pack, but I'm also pretty sure I said that before, so not sure how sure I can be. So I was, what I was saying is basically the run was hardcore in a sense that people were just like super, super trolly and gave me a very, very hard time. And in the end, we weren't successful. Like, just to put this very, very openly and very blunt, we haven't been successful because shit was just not working out. Yeah, fuck you, sick dude, for getting inside of the car. Wow, 33 enemies, and we got one of our soldiers killed, which is really bad. I feel for him. That was the first specialist that we lost within the whole campaign. At the moment in time when I triggered the second pot, I knew, okay, probably we're going to lose him. Like, this was a, I would say, 70, 80, 90 plus percent chance that we would lose him. But it still sucks if things are then really turning out as such. Yeah. Pretty, pretty sad. Pretty, pretty sad. But I think we therefore got a nice little promotion here from our clowny friend. Yo, what's up, bro? Who you saw? You just got promoted, I think. Rip Blue, rip Blue. He was a good leader. I really liked him. He also had the first ability, pretty solid equipment and so on and so forth. So pretty much a shame. All right, the Joker has the first and the last laugh as always. He got himself Ever Vigilant for the as the very first ability, which, if he double moves, still allows him to take Overwatch shots afterwards or go automatically in Overwatch. Great ability, by the way. Great ability, I like it. And super high amounts of really, really nice everything. Wow. I am just a little bit concerned about us not being able to recruit properly. I promised Voronoi to recruit him, her, in this case, rather.
Maybe once this is all over, we should take this ship and go colonize one of their planets.
Here we go. And she has this little look upon her face, like, okay, we're dead serious now. Vornai, do you prefer to be a psi-operative or a specialist? I can offer you both, and since we got a recent opening in our specialist position, being a specialist actually will get you on the missions quite often. Wow, that's good. Alien alloys and delirium crystals. It's actually pretty decent. Black market, resistance HQ. No, black market, supply drops, resistance HQ.
Avenger plotting new course.
Market is open.
Only a scientist, unfortunately. I'm thinking about the superior conditioning, which is really good. 4 hit points do not hurt at all. Do we need any other contact at the moment? No, we have only already made the contact, and we're probably not getting that so easy. So yeah, superior conditioning it is. 4 hit points are really great, guys. I can highly recommend using conditioning just as superior scopes. Vornai, you still haven't answered, mate. So I assume for the time being that you want to be a specialist.
Setting course for Sector 5, India.
By the way, maybe the chat is lagging. I haven't seen any post mission comments, and I was pretty sure that you guys would mention something after this rather intense mission. Probably I'm again disconnected from the chat. Yeah, wounding is okay. That's really fine. I'm a little bit concerned about our specialist. Like, we're super thin on specialists, and we only got like Lars Timmermans, who, by the way, still needs a decent naming. And yeah, that's about it. We just got Kotov, and if Kotov is not there, like, we do have no one at the moment, which pretty much sucks. So we're making contact, we're finalizing it, and then we go for alien alloys.
Course for the Western European ward.
Look at that. She nearly is done with her training. She nearly is done with her training. She now got firing discipline, and then there's only the last training that's left. And let me introduce you to the last two abilities, which in my opinion are really, really great. So it's either lead by example or combined arms. Oh, right. Now finally the chat now the chat is working again. Wow. Okay. And of course I was wrong. Voronoi rather wants to be psi-operative. Question from the chat. I lost two soldiers on my third mission on my Ironman run. Start over or can I come back from that? Theoretically, you can come back from that. And my experience, the hardest mission in the first month is the retaliation mission, which is the fourth one. So I would suggest to you try the retaliation mission. If you survive it, go on. If you fail on the retaliation mission, don't look back. Just bad luck and start over. So, Warneye wants to be a psi-operative. I can do that, mate. You're fine with specialist. Yeah, I would want to get you on specialist because you are really one of the noticeable specialists together with Wangstra. Like that's your signature class, and it would be cool to have you on it. I don't think so. We're all stunned. Yeah, I was stunned as well. So let's look at the last two abilities. It's either plus one damage, which is quite nice as a flat out damage. It will multiply also with crits. Or, and I find that a little bit better, the difference between the leader's aim, the leader's will, and the leader's hack, and the actual will, hack, and aim of each of its surrounding soldiers. Half of it will be added to everyone else. So if you give her in the end game tracer rounds like superior scoping and so on and so forth, everyone basically receives a big bonus. Everyone receives a big bonus. 45 supplies, cool, I like it. And we got ourselves plus 5 Avenger power gratis on top of it. Cool. Cool story, brah. Soon it's going to be the next retaliation mission, and I'm not looking forward for that. If you look at it, retaliation strike 2 weeks, shit. Nah, not good. I don't like it. But there is yet another gas bomb, and that's exactly what we were looking for. More gas. In terms of proving grounds, let's take a look. One skull check doesn't hurt. It's actually quite good, to be honest. And it could also help us to reduce the Avatar project. Vorna, is there any reason not to run six Psi operatives? On Legendary Ironman, there's a pretty good reason to train two Psi operatives to a point where you can master most of the skills and be like super OP takes 5 to 6 in-game months. So if you're down to play in playing 2 years in-game, six Psi operatives are by far the strongest team that you can imagine, by far. But the majority of guys are not down to 2 years of in-game for gaming. So it'll probably take you up to, I would say, 120 to 130 in-game missions if you're doing all of the missions. Proximity mine, not bad, I like it. Let's go for beam cannon next. We're getting the guns now, all of the guns. And finally, there's the Psylab, guys. There is the Psylab. And not only a Psylab, we're directly upgrading it because, yeah, why not? Like, we want to have two Psy operatives. And whilst we are at it, how about building items, by the way? How about, first of all, finding out that we again have two less Ilarium to upgrade the gun? Fuck it. But how about we are actually recruiting someone to become a Psy operative. Strelok, are you in the chat, man? Do you want to be a Psy operative? Who is he? He was one of the new ones as well. All of these are pre-generated characters. Koa, are you in the chat? Do you want to be a Psy operative, brother? Velius, you could be one. Can I be a Psy operative? Yeah. Ready to snap and Nitro Glick it is then. Ready and Nitro, I'll give you two new characters though, just to give you some handsome characters here. So Robert Robertson, we're going to rename them once they are available, once they are trained. Like, I'm just shortly going to modify them. And the only thing that I would suggest as a psi operative, because it's really, really imbalanced and looks absolutely great, is if the guys are having a darker tone, because their hair is going to be like super white and their eyes will be all glimsy. So if you're down for like this a little bit darker tone of color for your character, that actually would look pretty sick when they are becoming psi operatives. Like this guy here will look very, very decent if he when he's a psi operative. And we do have Robert Robertson as well, whom we just need to shortly modify as well. Race, yeah. How about hair? I'm looking for these Rastafaris because they were always like very nice. Damn, where are the Rastafaris? The dreadlocks. Probably because he's not high enough in level. I need to install the mod, which is then you just have the parted hair and look a little bit like a douche, but a positive douche. So Robert Robertson, and I'm not meaning douche in a negative sense here, just to not be misunderstood. You're just looking very bro handsome. So that here is ready to snap. Just to, it's Robert ready to snap. And we do have as our second psi operative, Nitroglick. It is not Mariner, it is Michael with his first name, and they call him Nitroglick. I will give them nicknames when they are on the respective rank. For now, we can't give them nicknames, but their nicknames will be your nicknames, so don't worry, guys. These two gentlemen will be our psi operatives, and if everything turns out well, they're soon becoming like super, super strong. So currently, they should be sitting like down here. Workshop Gremlin kind of helping them to train faster. Yeah. Good. So this is it with psi operatives, and I think we're okay for now. Review targets. Oh, wonderful. Berserker packs on every mission for 1 month. That is pretty shitty, a dark event. I don't like it at all. Mind shielding, I couldn't care less. And that's a hidden event, which is probably also bad. So we have the decision between very bad, not so really bad, and something that we don't know. Since it's destroy the alien relay, we can still do it. No, it's absolutely no problem, bro. You want to have a wild armor pad on, short hair, a cigar and cigarette. You will get all of these. These gimmicks, unfortunately, are not unlocked all for rookies, so let me train these guys up. And name will just be Nitro. Fine. That is absolutely cool. I remember this one, Nitro. Don't worry. Don't worry. So these guys here are going to carry the mission. It's going to be, again, two grenadiers. Like, very difficult. Is not looking fine. Hey, Roselle. Wow. You're nearly spelled, or your nickname is pretty close to one of my favorite artists. There's a very nice beatboxer called Roselle. And, yeah, maybe that was a reference to him. If that is the case, then cheers, mate. Okay, so this guy here also has 9 hit points. Not the best place to start your XCOM career if you do have 9 hit points. I can tell you that much. So our healer is actually going to get the nanoplate vest, and we need to be very careful. If your mother only knew, right? Yes, it is indeed if your mother only knew. But he did more than that, but of course that's like his theme song, and he had some pretty decent musical skills as well. Oh no, more than decent. He was really good, let's be honest. Decent would be a pretty nice understatement. Okay, so blue screen rounds, blue screen rounds, blue screen rounds. I have no idea whom we are going to find on this mission. So, yeah, we do have a couple of blue screen rounds, so I'm not super worried. And I think we should be fine. And I don't expect to take damage anyways. The only thing that I could ask for is like, no, I don't want to give you the superior conditioning, man, because that is something that we're going to give for Voronoi. I want to use Voronoi anyways a little bit more than I'm using him. So if we talk about plasma rifles, like what's up? Let's give him one with an advanced scope, so he at least has a chance to take some shots. Yeah, and that's mainly about it. Good Lord. What's up with you, who you saw? Like your loadout? No, that's fine. You basically, by the way, you also could use some more hit points. So, if it wasn't for the priority for healers, I would definitely give you the plus 4 hit points. But the healers need the hit points the most because they need to survive. That's the way it is. Can't change it, man. You just need to be in cover. That's it. Good, so let us go Ah, the Raziel from Legacy of Kain. That's cool. I see, I see. Roby, the PvPing. We could certainly do that in the future. I'm down to do that, but I have played exactly 0 sessions PvP so far, so I would need to definitely look into it a little bit to do some reasonable to do reasonably well. But in general, I'm cool with it. So yeah, why not? Begin the mission. You have a distinct advantage though, because you can snipe the stream and at the same time play. Yeah, no need for hit.